Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're looking at the Red Hat 124 course and looking at some of the new features in CentOS and Red Hat 7, and it's looking at our password quality. In previous edition of Enterprise Linux, CentOS and Red Hat have depended on the PAM module cracklib, which does a dictionary check and basic complexity check of our passwords, but that has left very little as administrators where we can implement password policies. Part of the RH124 course now, and consequently your RHSA exam, is going to be looking at your password policies. So to manage this, we go through into the directory etc security. And within this directory, we have configuration files that are used to configure the pluggable authentication modules, our PAM modules. And it's a PAM module, PAM_pwquality, that is managing the password complexity now. If we take a look at our policy file, it's not too much, pwquality.conf, then we can see some of the settings. This differs from the standard file. I've gone through and cleared out some of the comments and changed some of the values just for simplicity. But what we're looking at on the first line, diff OK, we're looking at the number of characters in your new password that must be different from your old password. What we don't want is, once I've got a good password, me just appending a new letter or number to the end of it, just changing one character. At the moment, with it set to zero, we're not implementing it, but we might go diff OK to two to say, well, we must have at least two different characters, or maybe diff OK equals three. The space between the directive, the equals, and the value is important. Can't have them all pushed up, or it doesn't recognize the setting. We're setting our minimum password length to 6, which is the minimum that we can go to, but obviously we wanted a longer password, we could enforce that. Minimum class, we're really not implementing anything there. We're saying that we want at least one class of character, which of course we must have if we have 6 characters. A class of character, we have 4 classes. Uppercase and lowercase characters, digits, and others. And others would be characters such as the ampersand or the percent sign, so non-alphanumeric characters. And we can see the classes being listed here are uppercase, others, lowercase, and then our digits. So we say we have to have at least one class, but we would have to have at least one class anyway to have one character. Maximum repeat. Here we're looking at saying, well, yeah, I can't have any more than 6 repeating characters. So that does actually allow me to have a password of 111111. So we might change some of that, but we can leave that at the moment. Max class repeat is turned off at the moment. The value is 0, and that's indicating how many consecutive characters of the same class must I have. If I set that to something like 1, every character then would have to be a separate class from the previous character. So I'd have to go uppercase, lowercase, etc. The GCOS check is checking the password file. So we have a GCOS field in there, which often is our full name. So it's looking then to make sure that I don't use my first name or my last name in the password, but it's currently turned off. The decredits is really looking at how many credits we give to our score if we include a digit. Same as L for lowercase, O for others, and U for uppercase. So we can affect our score. But if I wanted to enforce that I had at least one digit, I would set it to -1. If I want at least 2 digits, I'd set it to -2. So we can see this working. If I go through, and we'll just try at the moment, and we can test our score for a password, even without changing it. So we're not enforcing that we have to have digits at all at the moment. But if I use the command pwscore, I'm running this as root only because I wanted to get into the configuration, but this is an ordinary user command. So if I use pwscore and then enter, and you'll see what I'm implementing. So if I, you know, put some kind of weird stuff, which hopefully should be, you know, a reasonably good password. So as we go through, actually, let's take the lowercase character out from that. Okay, let's just go through on that. We can see then that we've got a password score of 65. But if we wanted to, let's say, enforce that we have to have at least one number, let's go through and, or lowercase, let's say, it doesn't really matter. So sorry, I want to edit my configuration file now. So let's go through for lowercase and say that we must have at least one lowercase character. So I set that to -1. And now when we go through and run pwscore, if we set it for p1 instead of pl, and then 34@34, then we can see that our policy has kicked in. We contain less than one lowercase character. We don't have too much else in. So again, if I go through and do something like this, put password in properly, and again put our one digit. Oops, let's go pwscore, and then password one. So even though we meet our policy, ultimately we still do a dictionary check at the end, so we still can't include words that are based on dictionaries. If we go back in and edit our file, if we go through and say something like max class repeat and set that to 2. So if we go through now and try and set our password with pwscore, and we can then have, so all of this would seem like a reasonably good password. But when we look at it, because we've got a relatively long string, TOOTP in the middle, then it's not accepting it. Whereas if we change that slightly, so go back in and we'll set PA33 colon or semicolon, and then we'll have capital TOO capital TP34, then that's given me the highest score of possible for a password of 100. The password score run from 0 through to 100. So hopefully this gives you an idea of some of the things that are new in Red Hat and CentOS 7, and an idea of how we can implement secure password management through Enterprise Linux 7. Thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you back on theurbanpenguin.com soon.